Improve the understanding of the Guru Yoga through receiving the more the teachings on it. Now, when we do this Gandhan Hatyama and the practice of Guru Yoga, and then first of all, we should invite the merit in the field, and then in offerings and dedications and so forth. And first of all, it is very important to know the reasons why we have to do the Guru Yoga. And it is said that making offerings, doing this Guru Yoga, when we receive the great amount of merit, and if one do need merit, and then one should do this the Guru Yoga. It is said in the text that if one offers, to a spiritual guide, and then one will receive the more merits. Then making offerings to the Buddhas, such as the food, drink, and other the substances, and also one should see the reasons why the Guru Yoga is very important. And by doing this the Guru Yoga, and then one will receive merit. If one do need merit, then one should do this the Guru Yoga.
Rangi Kalo de Sati, do the Chong was Chong Yero Man, Chong Yim Bekusha. Chong was a regular yard. Regular decisions in Chile yard. Say the Tumbushagani, as if Chile. They gone in Tumbuya party of Chirachi, turned on the Chinja to the Chirajia You are changing the Gumer's room. Tumble in Jaraji in a past. She rushed out to the job. Jaraji is no longer. What did you go on the US music? The Jamon was used as unit. What did they set up? Some of them. They stumbled on the Gadeshi Rambu Gova, the Sandu Yabo Dongwin, the Tabishi Gova Sandu Dongwin, she jumped the pain. This Sandu Yabo Dona didn't.
And so when we should invite this our merit field from the Tushita, and where is this Tushita? and we should think it is above, you know, first of all, sorry, we should face our, we should face towards a northern direction. Even if we are not facing to a northern direction, we should imagine that we are facing towards northern direction and think at that, you know, direction, then there is Mount Meru, and on Mount Meru, then we should visualize the land of 33, and then after land of 33, then everything is kind of empty, it's all full of space, and above, and after the space, then we will reach the land of without fight, or without fighting. And for this land of, you know, the without combat or without fighting, and there is expanding, or the land of joy. And the actual, we should visualize the actual abode of the Buddha left this material is about 1 mile outside of the town, the Tushita. And and think that the that this this the actual abode of this this material is 500 spans long from the main city of, you know, the land of, you know, the joy. And then if possible, we should try to visualize this land of joy as elaborate as, you know, we can. Just thinking, and that that how wonderful if I myself we reborn in that land of joy, we create a great merit. And so one should first of all then visualize this land of joy as clear as one can.
That you told me that you got things this year, did not? You got a thing that you want to do it. Such a kind of thing. Seja sajila medu e memar hisu tiva soya ayu medu e sajila seji memar hisu tiva soya ayu tename naso ji ji resa.
And and the ground of this the land of joy or Tushita should be visualized as made of, you know, the lapis lazuli.
Ti na neji ji ne na neji ji ti na parche bas kongo ji sanu ma so ji ji ma kongo ji.
And to visualize also this in the base of this pure land, Tushita is made of gold and in other in the precious stones. And while the one stepping on this ground, one is actually, you know, one feels as if one is sinking into the ground, like if one jumps on a, you know, foam mattress. And you know, and when one wants to imagine and feel that one is, it's not very, you know, thus, that the ground of the Tushita is not very solid and hard like ordinary substances.
And
visualize, you know, this pure land, you know, joy, land of joy, very spacious and extensive, and around, you know, this this land, and then at different distances, and then one should visualize the jewel, you know, the
mountains.
And in the center of this land of joy, and then I want you to visualize, you know, the wish fulfilling tree in different colors. And on each, you know, the, you know, the wish fulfilling tree, and then there are the seven the precious the stones.
Shinge Dombo, Yaga, Loma, Medo, somewhere you mean. Maras Shinzuna, Devu Tabi Medo Yoma, Medo Shadin Devu Yoma. Tinema Yima, Devu Yoma, Medo Yoma.
And
Loma Yoma.
And visualize that these trees have flowers as well as the fruits. when there's the flower on the ordinary fruit trees, then there aren't no fruits. When there are fruits, then there aren't the flowers. Not like that, but on the trees which are in the land of joy, has everything: leaves, branches, flowers, fruits.
And visualize
these new trees are very attractive and has kind of decorations of decorations of hanging the ornaments. And in blowing and wearing of the very cool winds. Because of this, then these trees making the sound. They making the sound of the dharma. And think that whatever one wants and wishes for, then one obtains.
And everything that one desires from those jeweled trees.
Then one should visualize the jeweled ponds, and visualize the base of the ponds that made of the jewels, and around these ponds, then one should visualize the jeweled trees, and some ponds actually do have the stairs. And I think that there are different colors of the water.
And the different distances,
and then I want you to visualize the jeweled
mansions.
And at the very center of these mansions, then one should visualize the mansion of where the Buddha Maitreya resides, and visualize the house of the Buddha Maitreya higher than others. And around the palace of the Buddha Maitreya, then one should visualize the fence. Buddha Maitreya himself is actually sitting on the throne, which has also, there's something behind him to support his back.
And visualize that
everything is in that the land of joy. There's nothing that is missed in that land of joy. And if one can also console in other texts, what one has to visualize besides what I've explained. Buddha Maitreya, and then Adisha and Jetsongkhapa are sitting next to him.
Adishala Tsendu Nagatima Mevasa.
And the name of Adisha, who is residing in the Tushita land of joy, is Nagatima Me. And Jitsongkhapa, who is now residing in land of joy, his name is Jambenyuba Manchu Nagapa.
And both Vimala and Manchu, the Kapa, who are Jetsongkhapa and the Adisha,
are not in the form of the bhikshus or monks, but in the form of the deities. Visualizing about Manchu Kapa and Akash, this Vimala, are also wearing the ornaments and
other deities.
And there are many Indian apprentices who passed away, and they are born in the land of joy, and visualize those Indian teachers who are in the land of joy, she also visualize. And there are many the Tibetan teachers who are in this land of joy, and also those should be visualized around them. Touching on the earth, like you sit on the chair, and he is wearing the ornaments, and on the top of his head, then there is a stupa.
The reason the crown of the head
is that because to symbolize is the teacher, Shakyamuni Buddha was actually there. And at one time, Shakyamuni Buddha was the spiritual guide of Maitreya. So in order to be mindful of his teacher, and it Rinpoche said that Buddha Bhatia holds a stupa on the crown of his head. And his two hands in the gesture of Dharma Chakra, or granting the teachings, Dharma teachings, and the gestures exactly like the gestures of Tsongkhapa.
And the tongues and the four fingers
are holding the stems of the naga and the tree. The trees which are round, the tree which is around, but instead of a naga tree.
Nye ye tele mi do sha de mi do gon le ye lo kolo yo le